Hey, so thanks for getting me on this shoot. It's, you know, January. Things tend to be dead as a doornail.
Yeah, no problem. Thanks for coming out so last minute. It was all really rushed because I had to pitch this thing like 10 times to get it off the ground. But I'm excited. I think it'll be good.
For sure. I mean, it's always good to have somebody who's a pro on your shoot, you know, to make you look good for clients and stuff. I get it.
I think we've been doing this the same amount of time, but yeah.
I was up for one of those shoots about a year ago, but I didn't get it. Affirmative action, right? But hey, Jayne, you know, I'm really proud of you. I'm so stoked for you doing this, and I'm going to make this film look really good for you. It's going to make you look so good. So what's it about again? Girls in nature? What?
No, actually, it's about this colony of women who have been living in complete isolation for the last 300 years, just out in the wilderness.
It's just girls?
Mm-hmm. Didn't you get the treatment and shot list I sent over?
Let me get this straight. It's just a bunch of lesbos in the woods, right? How are they, like, procreating?
Chad, do you think you could move that light a little over to the right? Chad,
this is fine.
It's going to be too backlit and sourcey. I really think it needs to be moved over there.
Jayne, I'm an award-winning filmmaker. I don't need you to tell me where to put a light.
You know that I've made as many films as you have.
Yeah, but I mean, are you really proud of any of them? Watch out. So we're still like 4 miles away from these ladies. Why are we camping here tonight?
Because the colony doesn't trust outsiders. We'll meet with the liaison tomorrow and then we'll start the process of earning their trust.
Earning their trust?
To make them comfortable so we can film them.
Make them comfortable so we can film them. I'm only getting paid $600 a day, so if we're not done within, you know, one day, we're out of here.
You're getting paid $600 a day. Look. You can't just barge into someone's living room uninvited and be like, why do you live this way? And expect to get good results.
Well, why do they live like this?
They're refugees from the witch trials.
So we're out here hunting witches, okay.
No, we're out here trying to find survivors of generational trauma.
That sounds like an Etsy t-shirt.
The women were the protectors of this forest. The legend goes that men came to try and settle the land. And the leader of the town came with his new bride, Agnes Black. He started marking trees for what would be stores and shops and what have you. He found the biggest tree in the woods. He knelt down by the basin and carved their initials in it. He swore that all the trees started to bleed. He died. Shortly thereafter. And from that day on, every man that Agnes Black set her eyes on died a quick and swift death. These woods are protected by old magic.
That's very spooky. That's so spooky. So you mean to tell me if I litter, the Blair Witch is gonna come curse me?
No, I'm just trying to relay the folklore that the patriarchy has used to oppress these women for the last 300 years.
Okay, Jesus Christ.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna go get canceled by some old hags.
No, stop that, please!
It was Jayne! It's just a joke.
I need you to appreciate how hard I have worked.
What?
Nothing.
What is it, a bear?
No, nothing. It's my mind playing tricks on me. Can we just get the last few shots we need for tonight? Now the scene. Scene one, Apple take two.
You didn't say her. You have to say Mark first.
It's fine. Let's just move on.
No. Look, I'm just trying to save your editor some time in that bay from having to work with a green director.
And I'm saying you should do it yourself.
Marker, scene one.
Fuck, where are your keys? Where are your keys?
Back.